What's up, everybody? It's Omar here. Today we're going to be interviewing and hanging out with Mr. Chris Jocelyn. Fresh off the Plan B video, everybody's been going nuts. What's he up to? When's he turning pro? Yada, yada, yada. So today we kind of explore that a little bit, figure out who he is, and just talk skate, skate, skate all day. Enjoy.
In our age of advanced technology.
Venture, Bones, Active Ride Shop, Grizzly Grip Tape, Etnies Shoes, Idea 562 Stencils, Arnett Eyewear, Fred Water, LRG Clothing.
Yeah, it's like 12 sponsors?
Ethica sends me boxers.
I know this sounds crazy, but does it ever occur to you that like, every skater in the world would love to be in your position right now, just in terms of how big the Plan B video is and how iconic the team is.
I mean, any person can. All you gotta do is skate.
Yeah.
You just gotta skate and have fun. Keep at it. Just keep practicing.
What do you feel like is the difference between you and other dudes who progress or come up, like maybe as quickly as you did, versus other dudes who might not? Like, is there anything you notice in terms of their approach to skating or yours that gives you that extra kind of advantage or that's benefited you know what I mean?
I just try to skate every day. That's the only thing I do. So it's kind of like I don't really pay attention to other people's strategies, but all I can say for myself is I just skate every day. And that seems to help me out.
Do you notice that you're less scared than most people to try certain shit? Or you don't even think about that at all?
I wouldn't say I'm less scared than people to try certain shit, because there's probably somebody that'll walk right up to a 20 stair hammer without even looking at it.
Nigel.
And I'll be like, yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So Nigel Houston, for example. Dude, I heard this guy when he rolls his ankle, he just asked his filmer Chris Ray, he's like, yo, you got a 30 stair for me to grind? A rolled ankle, because he can't flip his board, I guess, so he'll just grind a big ass rail. Like, that's insane, dude. With a rolled ankle, I'd be sitting in a freaking ice tub, like, nice. Chilling.
What advice do you have to other skateboarders out there looking to, like, go hammer, get sponsored, or, you know, get fucking gnarly?
If you skate every day, the right thing will happen. That's all I can say.
Like, what would you say is the worst injury you've had off skating?
Tore my ACL trying to switch hard flip a 13 like 2 years ago. But it's not fully torn in half. There's just a slight tear in it. Mm-hmm. And with the help of physical therapy and this brace that Dr. Dave orders for me, I can like skate because it has like two metal rods that go down the side of it, which prevent my leg from going like in ways and out ways. So that's pretty cool.
And your legs fucked right now too, your knee, right?
Yeah, like I guess what had happened was the kneecap dislocated, and then the muscle structure brought it back in place.
Yeah.
But in that process, I guess chipped the kneecap.
Yeah.
So like there's still like a chip of the kneecap floating around and whatnot. But I'm supposed to have surgery as soon as the growth plates are out of the way, because I just turned 18, so I haven't went back for an MRI yet.
Mm-hmm.
And once I do though, and I figure out where the growth plates are, I'm gonna get that surgery.
And your whole Plan B part was filmed with the fucked up knee, messed up knee.
Yeah.
Damn.
We're about to go ride our skateboards.
Where are we headed to?
Right now, we're headed down the stairs to the cars and then to the skate park. We're going to start out with Peak Park. It's a local one right down the street. Takes about 10 minutes to drive. Maybe less, actually. It might only take like 6 or 7 minutes. Then we'll come back here, grill some burgers for lunch, then head to the dough, get a night sesh. It'll be a good day, as usual.
biggest influences of skating, Chris?
Andrew Reynolds was a big influence on me. I always thought he was an amazing skateboarder. And also, I watched one of Steve Barra's tutorial kickflips back in the days. Just on flat ground, me and my buddy watched it. And that was actually how we first learned how to kickflip. And that was when he taught me how to barrel flip.
What was your first skate video you ever seen?
First full-length skate video I ever seen? God damn, this fucking truck is tight as shit. I think it was like the Circa It's Time video.
Yeah.
And the DGK It's Official video.
Yeah.
When I was like 10 years old. Those were like the first official skate videos I've ever watched.
Were your parents pretty supportive about skating? Or?
Yeah, they were supportive since day one. My mom, my dad passed away when I was real young, so he never really was like there throughout too much of it. But my mom was really supportive. She would help out whenever she could, and my grandma was actually hella supportive too. She would help out more than she needed to, honestly. She'd take me to skate parks like 8 in the morning on the weekends when nobody's there, just so I could go have the park to myself and just have fun.
Are they hyped on you coming up nowadays, or how do they feel about it?
They're not really too well understanding of it. Found it. They're not really too well understanding of it, but I mean, shit, not too many parents are at the time when you're like turning 18 and you need to have a job and an income and shit and get your own place, and you're not really too well ready for it at the time. And then, I don't know, she just saw it as like I needed to go out on my own to try to figure out how to do it on my own. But at the same time, like, being where I'm at right now, like having as many friends as I have now through skateboarding, like, it wasn't even really like I got let out on my own. Like, I kind of had a whole nother family to go to in a way. Like,
yeah.
It wasn't even really like a stressor. It was pretty mellow, I would say.
Do they get hyped when you show them like magazine coverage? And
yeah, they did for a while. When I was living there, I would show them all the magazines I was in and stuff, and they would say it was cool. They'd be hyped on it.
Like, when you started getting sponsored and stuff, was that in the back of your mind, like, I want to go pro, or was it just kind of like, I just want to skate?
Oh, yeah, that's pretty much everyone's dream, I bet.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Just having a name on a board sounds so fucking sick. Be pro, shit sounds amazing. But, I mean, shit, it ain't easy. It's not like it happens overnight.
Yeah.
It's something people just don't see. People are, like, all hyped on Instagram videos, and I'm like, dude, when are you turning pro? When's your pro model coming out? All these comments are so crazy. It's like, dude, not even introduced as an am yet. These kids are like, when are you going pro? When's this? When's that?
So yeah.
Dude, not for a while. Chill out.
Yeah, man.
You'll be alright.
What about when tricks like scare you to like roll up to or try or jump on? Like, you just go anyways, or you don't really feel it that way? Like,
that honestly occurs most with handrails. I'm pretty scared with handrails, to be honest. They're not like the easiest things to go for.
Yeah.
But when I'm jumping down something, it's like, dude, I know how to kick my board away, and I know how to land on my own 2 feet. It's not like I'm gonna magically end up on my head somehow. It's like, if you know how to fall, and pretty much, it's all. That was actually one of the first things I had to learn how to do was fall. When I first got to a skate park.
Yeah.
I started eating shit, and I was like, oh my god, I gotta learn the safe way around this, otherwise I'm gonna be taking some hard toll, man.
Yeah.
So fuck. Pretty much, I just learned how to like pretty much roll it out or like slide it out, because the skate park I grew up skating is pretty slippery. But now when you go to the streets, you kind of gotta like figure out how to roll it out, because that shit will fucking cut your skin if you try to slide on that shit.
But impact wise, I mean, you jump down a lot of big shit.
Oh yeah, you just, like I said, you just kind of roll it out. Like, you ever jumped off a house?
Yeah.
You never jumped off the roof of a house?
Well, I've
never,
jumped off
as
high
a kid,
shit.
Never done that. No way.
Off high shit. Yeah, I'm jumping off high.
Okay,
shit.
Okay, well, if you notice, you never really, well, most of the time, and depending on how. What stability you have, but most of the time you land and you like tumble kind of, right?
Yeah.
It's the same way with skateboarding. When you kick out the trick, you land on your feet, you tumble, that way you don't take all impact to your knees and ankles and legs and shit.
Yeah.
And the next day you're not sore because you have it like all going through your body. But it's like,
yeah,
you'd probably be sore like if you learned it at an older age where your body's not used to it. But as a kid learning how to fall as a kid, it's kind of like, you don't really get sore doing it now.
Do you, like, when you skate a big stair set, do you just ollie at first, or what's your ritual?
Yeah, ollie.
You just ollie and then go
just
for
ollie,
it.
Ollie, and depending on the trick, like if I'm trying like a back 360 kickflip, I like to warm up with back threes first. Or if I'm doing a frontside flip, I'll do a front 180 first or something. Or if I'm doing a switch flip, I'll do switch ollie first. Or fakie flip, fakie ollie maybe or something, just to get the feel right.
Yeah. Cool.
Just depending on the trick, pretty much.
We're at OC Ramps. First we hit Peak Park, got some pizza, hung out, talked skate psychology. Now we're at OC Ramps for the third part of the day in the life. Next, we go to El Dorado Park, but right now it's OC Ramps. Enjoy.
What's up, dude?
What's up?
How you doing, man?
Good, how are you?
All is good. Busy. Yeah, I didn't get a super big heads up. So anyways, the shop is kind of a mayhem. We're preparing a bunch of ramps and stuff. So there's a bunch of lumber out and about. Yeah, it's not too organized, but yeah, we pull out the rails, the boxes, the ledges, whatever, and then obviously the half pipe's good to go too. So whatever you want to skate, go hit it up.
Yeah, we'll go line that up right now. See, there's like a box right there, a flat bar. Get out of there and see the mini ramp outside.
Alright.
Let's do this. Thanks, Tyler.
For sure, man.
Alright.
We're about to hit the dough. Skated some more. It's pretty much how my day usually goes, so hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did. Hope to see you guys again soon.
If you guys enjoyed that interview, check out more to come. We got some big time pros and some other successful people that you guys might find interesting. Just check out my channel, like and subscribe, enjoy the interviews. Let us know what you think in the comments. Peace. Skate or die.